Hello, in this video I'm going to give you a sneak peek of how I create BX fonts in Embrilliance StitchArtist. Now in order to do this, you will need StitchArtist level 3, and that's to create native BX fonts. So you can see here, I'm going to zoom out just for a little bit. I've done some of the work here, I've gotten to the letter N, but I am not quite done yet. Creating a font is a tedious process. It takes a little bit of time and just to get it totally right. A couple of things you need before you create a font. First, you need some basis on which you're going to create these letters. Now, this is just an image right here of these black letters. And this image I created by typing out all of the letters in a font in a graphics program like Photoshop to make an image. This particular font is a 100% freely available font for me to do whatever I want with it. I don't want to take a font that is owned by somebody else. Oftentimes I'll take free fonts and then distort them in some ways. And this one, I'm pretty much digitizing it as is, but thickening it up in places because these very, very thin areas are not going to look great for satin stitches. So you can see my versions over on the left are a little bit thicker than that. So each letter you can see here, I create as a new object. So I'm on the O right now. Let's just go ahead and create the O. I'm going to zoom in and I am going to use my column tool right here. And then I'm just going to create, and like I said, I'm going to make it a little bit wider than what it actually is in the picture. So that's a little column right there. And I stopped because I don't want to have it underneath the column going that way. So I'm just going to make another column. And I am using my column tool and holding down my command key because what that will do is it'll make these points that I'm putting down curves. And that will give it a nice smooth finish. So as you can see, this is quite tedious. It's great TV work if you're looking for something to do while you're watching TV. And I'm just going to cover the entire letter. So let me just finish this part up to here, and then I will stop and I'll show you what I do next. So as you can see on the right, as I complete each letter, I put it into a new design. And that keeps it separate. Then I label them all after the letter itself. This is going to be capital O, U, U standing for uppercase. Now, if this particular letter set had smaller letters and lowercase letters, then that would just be plain O. And if I had numbers and punctuation marks, whatever, I would name them after that as well. Now, once I get these all, now they're not perfect. I got to go back and make some adjustments. That looks a little bit wonky there. And I would complete that letter in just a bit. I save it often because I don't want to lose my work. Now, once I get each of the letters done, then I'll go back and let's just look at the A for now. And I've also thought about sizing as well. Each one of these letters that I'm working on, you can see each square is about an inch. So I'm making these letters to be about 2 inches. That's kind of a good middle of the road size. I probably want to make them available to people from between like 1 inches to 4 inches. So 2 inches seemed like a good place to start. Now, I'll obviously test it at those sizes and make sure it looks good. So let's work with E, for example, because that one's just right there. And I'll zoom in a little bit, move it over. Okay, so with the E is comprised of 4 points for each, 4 columns. For each one of these columns, I'm going to select them all, and I'm going to choose this little button right here, which is branching. And when you branch your font, what it does is it tells Embrilliance to stitch it out like as a one piece. And it's telling me the start point is here and the end point is here. Well, I want that. I usually move it over something like this. So I come in kind of on the left bottom and I finish on the right bottom. That way, you know, as we do subsequent letters, the jump stitches are going to be kind of at the bottom and not kind of all over the place. So that is pretty much it. The E is done. I've branched it. It looks pretty good. The final step is creating the BX font set. And that option is located under the Create menu, and we choose Publish and then Fonts. Now, I have a whole bunch of different settings here. My default size, I usually use the M as a guide. I would want to go check out that size, but I know that I've made it about 2 inches, which is 50 millimeters. How small? I want to give the minimum version, 25, let's say. That's going to control how much the user can scale it. And I'll let them scale it up to about 100 millimeters. That's 4 inches. The current height is 50. So the default size, sorry, I don't think I explained that great well. The default size is how big the letters will come in when the user just starts typing with them. Then I name the font. If I don't hit this button, then I can get a sneak peek of it. So I'm just going to go ahead and say okay. And I don't know exactly what I'm going to call this font, so it's just called Classic Preppy Monogram. But let's just create a new page. And because I've done a little preview of it, it's going to show up in my list right here. Classic Preppy Monogram. And I can see what it looks like. I could type. I'm not going to have all my letters because remember, I haven't finished past M. But I can see what each one of these looks like. And even if I type lowercase, it's going to do uppercase because it doesn't have a lowercase. And so let's just see what that looks like. And there are my letters. Now, when I'm ready to actually save this as a file, I would click that little button in the publish settings, right? Publish fonts, this little one right here, and it will make it an official. It'll save it out as a BX file. So that is how you create a native BX font in Embrilliance StitchArtist. You must have level 3 in order to be able to do this.